being charged. You understand? What happened? Hello? Was it not being recorded, beta? We had already begun. Doesn't matter. So, and, yes, what are you saying, beta? Okay. And if this is short circuit, what is the meaning of short circuit, beta? When two wires, they melt and join together, and too much of electricity is passing through those, from that portion, and it may cause fire. That is called a short circuit. So due to these accidents or this phenomena, fuse is a must in a circuit. You understand? To avoid accidents. So what is a fuse? Let's see. Start with it.
Description of fuse. A fuse is
essentially
a thin wire made of an alloy with a melting point slightly below the melting of the conducting wires. Location it is fixed between two clamps of copper mounted on a porcelain
wires.
In domestic circuit, the main fuse is usually installed just after the main switch.
Okay, fine. So what is the description of fuse? A fuse is a thin wire. It's a thin wire. If in the circuit we are using thick wire, for example, this is the thickness of the wire in the circuit. So generally in the fuse we are using very thin wire. Okay? We are using very thin wire. Why? And this melting point is less than the melting point of the other wires which we are using in the circuit. Remember that. Because, for example, if the melting point of the fuse remains the same, then the devices which are connected in the circuit will all get burnt. So as not it to happen, what we do with it? We take the wire of a fuse with the melting point below the melting point of the conducting wires. You understand? So that it automatically melts, breaking the circuit. And the devices in the circuit remains protected. Where is it located? It is in between the clamp, like this. The copper mounted clamp, there's a copper and you got a wire in between. Where do you get this main fuse? After the main switch. And I will show you. Usually we get this main switch outside the house. Have you observed that? Maybe if you go to your grandma's place or the old bungalows or the old society, you can see the main switch is outside the house. And MCB is inside the room. Yes or no? MCB is inside the house and the main switch is outside the house. Yes or no? Okay? This is what is fuse. Can you see this fuse? This is fixed. This is a fixed part. The one on the right hand side. Can you see this? This is the fixed part. And this is the removal part. You have to remove it. And the wire is over here. Can you see over here? The wire. So this wire is like this. The wire melts from here. So it breaks the circuit. What happens? Fusing or the melting of the fuse breaks the circuit. Okay? So there is no passage of electricity. So generally we apply a thin wire like this. And when the fuse We said that the fuse is gone. What does it mean? That means the wire has melted. And the wire melts, it breaks the passage of electricity. Got it? Hello, boys.
Yes.
Yes, okay.
Yes, ma'am.
This is the working of the fuse. Any problem regarding this, beta?
No.
Now we are using MCBs. In the school, you must have observed above the door, on the wall, you have got the small, small units. Have you observed that? In each and every room. Yes, that is called as MCB. So this is miniature circuit breakers. Can you see this over here? Automatically, this comes down. See, it comes down automatically. If it gets tripped, if there's something wrong in any circuit, it will show. These are called phases. What are these called, beta? Phases. If you have got four rooms, or you've got five rooms, you've got two rooms, whatever, same number of miniature MCBs you can use. You can use an MCB with one switch. You can have two, you can have three, as per you have the rules. Is it clear? You can see this is a fuse over here, and these are the MCBs. Can you see this over here? So it's got the one, it's got two, yeah. It's got three. Can you see this? So it depends how many switches yeah. you can have with one MCB. Got it? I hope now you understood the difference between fuse and MCB, beta. All of you?
Yes.
Yes? Okay. So fuse is outside the house and MCB is inside the house. You understood now? Yes? And in the fuse, the wire gets melted, so it breaks the circuit. And in MCB, what happens? The switch trips off. It falls down automatically. And it breaks the circuit. So if something is wrong in this room, it will not spread to the other room. You understand?
Yes.
Yes? Okay. We will do some more detailing about fuse. Yes, beta. If you can
explain.
Okay, beta. If you can explain, you can. Okay, now it's all easy. I've already done the explanation. We are again revising it with another slide. And if you wish to explain it more.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, beta, start.
A fuse is a household device which is based on the principle of heating effect of electricity. A fuse consists of a wire that breaks when high electricity is passed through it. This can break in the circuit and prevent the current from entering devices and causing damage to the devices and possible fire.
Read better, continue.
MCBs are also safety devices used in households, like fuses and MCBs to break the circuit or go off automatically by overload and through the circuit.
Okay. Now, can you explain what is fuse? Can anyone? Can anyone explain better? What is the fuse and what is MCB? In your own words, if at all you wish. What do you want me to? Hello? Can anyone explain?
Yes, ma'am.
Can you explain, beta? Whatever Sahil read out just now. Can anyone explain?
Yes, ma'am. Fuse holds safety devices.
What is important in fuse? The wire. What is important in fuse? The wire. The safety device is done by this wire. Why? By melting. By melting, it gives the safety to the devices which are connected in the circuit. So what effect that we are talking about? A heating effect of electricity. That's why it melts, isn't it? Electricity gives the heating effect to the wire and it melts, disconnecting the circuit. So what is this fuse? It has a wire. It breaks when high electricity passes through it. That means it is breaking the circuit. So the current cannot flow. Current flow stops here only. The current flow stops here. And it does not damage the devices and maybe a possible fire. Hope you understand.
Yes, ma'am.
Now, what is MCB? These are also safety devices. This MCB is also breaking the circuit and automatically.
Yes, ma'am. This is the main switch of house.
Yes, and automatically it trips off if there is an overloading. That means too much of current is flowing to the circuit. Automatically, switch falls. It trips off. You got it? It becomes off automatically. If it senses, if it detects that there is too much of, if it's too much of electricity, it automatically goes off. You understand? So what it is doing? It is breaking the circuit. And the devices which are connected in the circuit, they are protected. Do you understand? The only difference between the fuse and MCB is that I told you earlier, fuse is outside the house. Generally, you just find it out. If you go to bungalows, the old ones, if you go to your grandpa's place, there's a box outside the house onto the wall. Is it clear? And whereas nowadays, MCB is fitted inside each and every room, most probably. Got it? Do you agree with me?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, done. So, any problem regarding these two safety devices?
No.
Okay. Okay, miniature circuit breaker, MCB. Please begin. Please, Vita.
Okay, ma'am. Miniature circuit breaker MCB are designed to overcome the trouble in fuse. Okay. An MCB is placed in the series in the live wire in a circuit and switched on to complete the circuit.
Then
working whenever the circuit gets overloaded. What, ma'am?
Read properly.
Working whenever the circuit gets overloaded, the components in the MCB sense the danger and automatically goes into the off mode.
Thank you. Now, what is MCB? If there is any trouble in fuse, it overcomes the trouble in fuse. What happens in fuse? We have to again put the wire, connect it, and remove the socket, remove the wire which is burnt, and again put a new wire, and again put it in the fixed position, fixed matter. Is it clear? The fixed holder. This much of work you have to do. Where is the MCBs? You don't have to do anything. You have to just put it on. That's it. You understand now? So what is the advantage of MCB as compared to fuse? You understood? We have to replace the wire in fuse. In MCB, you don't have to do anything. You have to just switch on. Now, how this MCB is placed? It is placed in series. Remember, we talked about series and parallel? Hello? Boys, do you hear me?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah. So it is placed in a series, one after the other, in a circuit. And when we switch it on, it all works in series in the circuit. Whenever the circuit is overloaded, that means it is having lots of electricity, means electricity is high. So the components which are in the MCB, it can detect the danger that something may go wrong. So automatically, it becomes off. You understand? Do you understand? Hello?
You understand?
We'll talk about earth wire.
Mommy, are
you? Yes, you can, beta. Who is it? Sanraj? Who wants to read?
Me, yes, ma'am, I read.
Now, who, you read it just now. Who wants to read? The... Sanraj, you read it just now, isn't it?
Yes,
I'm reading. Sorry.
Who wants to read now? Sheikh?
Sanraj wants to read now.
Who? Who is it?
Mahida Sanraj.
Okay.
Read. Oh,
just now spoke. Yes, I need your son. Start reading, whoever.
Okay, ma'am. Earth wire. The wire plays an important role in the electrical connections. All metal bodies of various devices, such as electric ions, electric refrigerator, television must be connected with the earth wire. To do this, one end is connected to the appliances and other end is connected to...
Just a moment, Peter.
Connected to earth working in case of leakage current, all current will flow to the earth directly.
So what is the usage of earth wire? It is very important in electric circuit. Whatever metallic devices, for example ions, refrigerators, TV, all these connection must be made with the earth wire. How they do it, Beta? One wire is fixed to the appliance. That means one wire is connected to TV or the refrigerator or the electric iron, and the other is connected to the earth. You understand? How it takes place, let's see. Now, there may be leakage of current. Yes, maybe there's a cut in the wire. There's a break in the wire. There must be some leakage in the current. That leakage should not come in the circuit. It should go into the earth. So they go, the current flow directly to the earth. You understand? Hello? The extra leakage of the current go directly to the earth and the earth absorbs it. Do you understand or not? Regarding the earth wire? Boys,
yes, ma'am.
If there's a leakage of current in the circuit, this goes into the earth wire and it goes directly to the earth and the earth absorbs it. Okay, so there's no spark created, there's no electrocution, so it gets earth. Okay? Hello? Do you understand? Do you understand better? So if at all maybe there's leakage of current
and attacks
something you get sometimes you when you touch certain instruments you get the current. Don't you get the current? But you don't die. You get the shivers. But you don't die. Why? Because most of the leakage, most of the lead current has gone down to the earth. You understand? So we are saved. Let's see how this earthing system works.
Yes.
Now this is the electricity, lightning. This is the lightning. Like this you get. It falls onto the house. This is lightning arrester. You get a rod. There's always a rod onto the flats, which are high-rise flats. You got rods. Those are called as lightning arrester. What are they called as? Lightning arrester. The electricity or the lightning which comes, it is arrested by this pole and then it goes to the box, which is known as electric service board. What it is called is better? Electric service board. It goes into this box. From there, it goes to earth wire. So from there, you can see this earth wire. Can you see this earth wire better?
Yes.
And then they make a pit somewhere near the society. They make a pit. Okay. And they put one electrode over here, which is called a safe earthing electrode. Nothing goes wrong over here. And they fill it up. What do they do? They fill up. If at all, the current which it has got through the earth wire, it all gets released. You can see this current is, the leakage of the current is dissipated. What is dissipated? But it is absorbed by the earth. So earth has taken all the current. Any problem? This is how it does. You should know that in building, these are the wires that we use. The live wire is red, the neutral wire is black, and the earth wire is green. These are the wires that we are using in the cable. Any problem? So live is red wire, black is neutral, and green is earth. Got it? Hope you have understood how this earthing system is done in the houses. Yes, beta? Hello?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. Now, effects of electric current. Please go through.
Effects of electric current. Number one, heating effect. Number two, magnetic effect. Number three, mechanical effect. Number four,
chemical effect.
Chemical effect.
What is heating effect? It produces heat. Yes. What is magnetic effect? It behaves like a magnet. What is mechanical effect? It behaves like a machine. What is chemical effect? The chemistry of the substance. You understood? Understood better? Now we'll talk about heating effects of electricity.
Yes.
Please. Please better start.
Yes, ma'am.
To read.
Heating effects of electric current. Water heaters.
Geysers,
electric ions, room heaters.
It is geysers.
Geysers, electric ions, room heaters, etc. are some electric devices in which heat is produced. Electricity produces heat. That is part of the electric energy is converted into heat energy. This is called heating effects of electric current.
Fine. So what is heating effect of electric currents? Whenever the electricity is passing, it produces heat. That is what is the meaning. Where do you get this heat meter? You get in water heaters, which is called as geysers, that you are using in the washroom. Then you have the electrical irons. You're using the heat to iron your clothes. Then you have room heaters. You're using the electricity to heat your rooms. These are electrical devices where heat is produced. You agree? Do you agree better?
Yes, ma'am.
So we know that electricity produces heat. Now, this little bit of electrical energy is converted into heat, isn't it? Yes or no? It's converted into heat energy, which is called as
conducting
effect. And that's heat energy. We are using it for ironing, for warming the room, for warming the water, for heating the water. This is the property that we are using of electricity. You understand? So this is called as heating effect of electric current. Start, beta.
When electric current pass through the conductor, heat is produced. Large current, more heat.
Yes.
The change of electrical energy into heat energy is called heating effect of electrical current.
What is heating effect? Beta, you will not speak in between. You have to ask my permission, Beta. Sahil? Sahil? When someone is reading,
no,
you will stop.
Reading.
No, that is what I am saying. You will not read in between. Let the person complete. Then you have to take my permission. And then you have to start speaking. Is it clear, Beta? You will not speak in between. Am I clear, Beta? Hello? Sahil, did you understand? Thank you. So, when electric current is passing through any wire, through any conductor, we know heat is produced. So, if more current is there, that means obviously more heat will be produced. So, the electrical energy is changing into heat energy, which is called as heating effect of electrical current. The same thing in a different format. Let's see where are the application of heating effect. Please start.
Application of heating effect. Heater, geysers, toaster, oven are example of heating effect of electrical current. The element get heated up when current pass through it. Even when such device like electric bulb use this effect.
Where do we find this heating effect? Geysers, heaters, toaster, ovens. What happening over here? The element which is used in this devices, they get heated up. They become red hot when current is passed through it. And this red hotness converts to heat. Okay? So even in electric bulb, you can see the filaments. See, this is the bulb. You can see this filament. Yes or no? Yes. So what is this? This is element. So this element in the bulb gets heated up. It becomes red. And then that gives out heat. Because when you touch the bulb after some time, you find the hotness of the bulb, isn't it? Yes, beta?
Yes, ma'am. The element get heated up when current...
We have done it. We have already finished it, beta. Now, heating effect is over. Now, we are going to talk about magnetic effect. Please begin. Can anyone start reading?
This is called
magnetic effect.
अभी तो मैं और साहिल ही है, हम दो ही है, दूसरे सब चले गए।
कोई बात नहीं, मैग्नेटिक इफेक्ट पढ़ना शुरू कर दीजिए।
साहिल रीड कर।
मैम की स्क्रीन में नहीं आ रही है, बिल्कुल नहीं आ रही है मेरे में।
So can you see what happened? You leave and come again, rejoin again. Can you see my slide?
Okay, ma'am. I will rejoin.
Okay, Sandhas, can you see?
Yes, ma'am. Now it is coming.
Okay, then read.
Yes.
Don't rush. Don't rush. Read slowly. Okay.
The electric current is passed through. Don't rush. The electric current is passed through all of insulated wire coil around a soft iron bar. The iron bar behaves as a magnet. This is called magnetic effect. Electric current.
You're not clear.
Lecture is over. Their time is 10:11.
No, no.
This is called magnetic effect of
electric current. The magnetic effect disappears as current stops to flow. Okay. So what is magnetic effect? Whenever electric current is passing through a insulated wire, it's a coil. For example, this is a metal, right? Just observe. And there's a wire coiled on it. You got it now? When the electricity is passing, this will behave like a electromagnet. How it will behave it up? Electromagnet. Understood? So it will show certain features of magnetism. This iron bar will behave like a magnet. So what is this effect? This is called as magnetic effect of electric current. When you stop the flow of current, the iron bar will stop showing magnetic effect. You understand? So magnetism is present till the electricity flows. When it stops, it becomes ordinary iron. What you get in the doorbell? When you press the doorbell, you get the electromagnetism in the device, and which makes you hear the ringing sound of the doorbell. You understand, Vita? And when you stop, the ringing sound is gone. That means it does not behave like an electromagnet. Any problem? Do you understand, Beta?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes? Okay. You can see over here. I just showed you. This is behaving like a magnet. This is actually iron. Iron is covered by the coils of the wire. And these are the magnetic field. Can you see this? These are the magnetic field on the sides. The arrows which you can see. It's a magnetic field. Okay? This is a circuit. So this behaves like a magnet now. Yes. You can finish this slide with a
magnetic effect of electricity. A conducting wire behaves like a magnet. When electricity is passed through it, and hence the needle in the magnetic compass gets deflected.
You can see the magnetic compass, the needle gets deflected whenever the current passes through. We know that.
Factors on which magnetic effect of electric current depends. Number one, it is directly proportional.
Read properly.
Proportional to the number of turns in the coil.
Yes, ma'am. 1 minute. 1 minute.
Supreme.
Second, 1 minute, ma'am. I'm finishing it up.
Okay.
And second one is.
It is directly
proportional.
Proportional to the amount of current.
The first one is what? How many turns are there? More turns, more magnetic effect. Right? That is the first one. Second one, how much current is going through it? So more current, more will be the magnetism. Hope you have understood. That magnetic effect depends on what? Number of turns, number of coils on the iron, and how much of electricity is passing through the electromagnet. Is it clear? Is it clear better?